Hubble flew to space in April 1990 aboard the Space Shuttle Discovery. Its altitude, 335 miles 540 kilometers above Earth, as of late 2022, is now roughly 38 miles 60 kilometers lower than its initial orbit. Hubble continues to fall gradually, thanks to drag induced by Earth's atmosphere, which is whisker-thin, but not non-existent, so high up. Hubble remains in good health otherwise, thanks to 5 space shuttle missions to service the telescope and boost its orbit, the last of which happened in 2009. NASA retired the 30-year-old shuttle fleet in 2011, leaving no current servicing options. It has been approximately 3 decades since NASA astronauts embarked on a tremendously audacious mission to rescue the Hubble Space Telescope. At that time, this mission was considered one of the most audacious endeavors ever, conceived by scientists. In 1990, Hubble was launched into space with flawed optics, resulting in blurry images. Thankfully, the astronauts were able to rectify this issue and ensure the telescope's success. But wait, there's more to the story. The space telescope, floating gracefully around our planet, was initially built with the intention of being fixed by astronauts if need be. Fast forward to the present day, and this iconic telescope finds itself in a predicament once again, reaching out for assistance. NASA is deeply troubled by this turn of events, as they are currently grappling with significant financial woes. However, all is not lost. Thankfully, NASA has found a trustworthy ally in SpaceX, a reliable commercial partner, who vows to rescue them from the depths of despair. Currently orbiting about 332 million miles or 535 kilometers above Earth, it completes one orbit approximately every 95 minutes. But the Hubble Space Telescope is more than just a pretty picture taker. Over the years, it has collected vast amounts of data, providing invaluable insights into the universe. From our own moon to the farthest galaxies, with observations of supernovas and nebulas in between. However, space is a treacherous environment that poses risks to any man-made object that lingers there for too long. Unfortunately, the Hubble Space Telescope is no exception. Recently, it has been plagued by continuous incidents, casting its future into uncertainty. On November 29, NASA announced that Hubble had entered a safe mode due to a problem with one of its 3 operational gyroscopes. This gyro first triggered the safe mode on November 19, providing faulty readings. Although spacecraft controllers managed to restore Hubble's operations, problems resurfaced on November 21 and 23. Engineers are currently investigating the issue, and there is no estimated timeline for when science operations will resume. While Hubble can function with just a single gyroscope, there will be some loss of productivity, such as the inability to perform certain solar system observations. Originally equipped with 6 gyroscopes during the final shuttle servicing mission in 2009, 3 of them have since malfunctioned. The American agency is currently grappling with 2 major challenges. Firstly, despite being the wealthiest agency in the world, NASA is struggling to secure funding for a crucial mission to maintain the Hubble telescope. The estimated cost for servicing the Hubble, including the shuttle and a crew of 7, was a staggering $900 million. To make matters worse, there have been political debates, aiming to reduce the budget allocated to the telescope in 2024. In light of this, NASA is contemplating reducing the budgets of its 2 largest space telescopes, Hubble and Chandra, due to a significant decrease in spending on astrophysical programs. This reduction is necessary to accommodate the costly Artemis program. NASA had hoped for increased funding in its budget proposal for fiscal year 2024. Requesting $93.3 million for Hubble, and $68.7 million for Chandra, which aligns with previous year's budgets. However, these amounts only account for a little over 10% of the total budget for astrophysics, raising concerns. Secondly, while Hubble should have been out of commission by now, its scarcity of equivalents makes it more practical to continue its operations. NASA has already made substantial investments in, and currently operates the James Webb Telescope. Additionally, the future Nancy Grace Roman Telescope is nearing completion in its clean rooms. Even China is preparing to launch its own version of Hubble, called STEON, next year. Despite the ongoing calls to save or bring back Hubble, NASA has agreed to consider proposals for various types of service missions. It is now time to seek assistance from the private sector to address these challenges. SpaceX and NASA have teamed up to explore the feasibility of a proposal to elevate NASA's Hubble Space Telescope to a higher orbit using SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. The study, initiated by SpaceX and the Polaris program, aims to unravel the technical challenges associated with servicing missions. The investigation is expected to last approximately 6 months, and will gather valuable technical data from both the Hubble telescope and the SpaceX Dragon mission. This information will be crucial in determining the feasibility of safely docking the telescope and maneuvering it into a more stable orbit. The Polaris program, in collaboration with SpaceX, plans to conduct up to 3 human spaceflight missions to showcase groundbreaking technologies. The first mission, Polaris Dawn, is scheduled for the second quarter of 2024, and will see the Dragon spacecraft carrying 4 astronauts to an altitude of 870 miles above Earth. The partnership between NASA, SpaceX, and the Polaris program is a promising development for the future of space exploration. This news comes after reports surfaced about technical issues with the telescope. However, Isaacman, the mastermind behind this proposal, believes that this mission could extend Hubble's lifespan by a decade and potentially bring it back to Earth for display in a museum using the Starship. He even suggests the possibility of repairing the telescope, highlighting the advancements in technology that have made it feasible. Not everyone shares Isaacman's optimism though, as some experts point out the limitations of the Crew Dragon spacecraft, which lacks an airlock and a manipulator arm. Moreover, while the mission is privately funded, NASA will still need to allocate time and resources for its preparation and support, which could pose challenges given the organization's budget constraints. The space community has also weighed in on Isaacman's proposal, with speculation suggesting that a spacewalk might be included in the second Polaris mission, drawing inspiration from a previous mission in 1993, when astronauts repaired the telescope manually. These repairs proved to be a turning point for Hubble, enabling it to capture some of the most breathtaking images of space. However, there are several concerns that arise when considering EVA suits and spacecraft engineering. One major issue is that the suits may not have enough maneuverability to effectively replace the gyroscope systems. Additionally, there is the challenge of containing the gyroscopes while the spacecraft is docked, as well as ensuring the proper orientation of the engines. The Crew Dragon's main engines are located beneath the launch aero cover and are evenly separated around the docking adapter, which can be seen as 4 black circles on the craft. It is likely that they will attach the prototype docking port, which is a prototype of the ISS port, on the rear trunk. This makes accessing the trunk interior extremely difficult. Furthermore, the Dragon craft will require modifications such as handlebars, making it even more challenging to service the Hubble telescope. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.